So today we are going to have a brief introduction to what are called volcanoes. So in the beginning I must tell you about the structure of the earth. The earth and similarly all planets and planetary bodies, they are built up of a solid core, inner core. Over that solid inner core there is a liquid outer core, and on that we have a mantle. On the mantle there is a thin layer which we call the crust. So the magma lies in the outer core, and this magma wants to escape to the surface of the crust, and that is what results in volcanoes. Volcanoes, they erupt at hundreds of places, and the molten magma which is in the outer layer of the earth after the solid, there is a molten layer, and thereon we have the tectonic plates, and on that lays the thin crust of the earth. So the magma in the molten form is there in the chamber, and it finds its way through a vent to the top layer of the earth, which means to the crust. It makes a vent, and thereafter it hot lava, which is a mix of rocks and liquid, ashes and gases of different kind, and they erupt out of that, and then that falls. Due to gravity it falls, and then in the different kinds of volcanoes that we have, different shapes are obtained. So normally what happens is that a conical thing is formed. Okay, from here, due to the pressure changes, due to many things which happen there, the molten lava, it finds its way to the crust of the earth. These volcanoes are normally where we have the tectonic plates, which I have talked about before. They either are diverging or they are converging, and at those points, at the boundaries, we get volcanic ruptures. In the volcanic ruptures that we have, is basically the magma which comes out in the form of lava, in the form of ashes, and in the form of gases. So many kinds of things happen. Fortunately, most of these volcanoes are in the bed of the oceans, and when that eruption begins and then there is a lot of pressure of water there, then that boiling lava and those things, they form mounds. The volcanoes, and there are several of them of different sizes all over the earth, and when it is active, then the lava comes, the ashes come, and the gases come. And the lava, it flows off the steep edges of the volcano, settles there layer over layer, and ash and lava and gases they come out. The composition of the gases can differ from one volcano to another volcano. Sometimes it is sulfuric acid gases, sometimes it is hydrogen fluoride, sometimes it is hydrogen chloride, okay, HCl, and other many kinds of gases are there. Volcanoes are dangerous to us because they spread. But the lava has got, sometimes it's very viscous and sometimes it's less viscous. If it is less viscous, then it spreads in the form of a plateau. When it is more viscous, then the shape becomes kind of, as I told you, kind of conical. So, fast moving lava can kill people and the habitat. Falling ash can make us hard to breathe. And houses, roads and fields are devastated, they are destroyed, plants and animals are killed. This often results in famines because of the hot molten lava and the ashes. However, if the ashes settle in those areas, the vegetation is very much possible and fast growth is there. So there are pros and cons of having these volcanoes. Weather also often changes, and sometimes after the volcanic eruption is stopped, there is so much radiation that the earth goes into a cold kind of an era, a short period of time when the temperature of the earth falls. Okay, so we have the scientists who work on the volcanoes. They are called volcanologists, and they have, in the due course of time, they have become better and better with the prediction of volcanoes. As I told you earlier, that the prediction of and study of the tsunami waves is well within our reach. The prediction of earthquakes is not possible. But with these studies, with more and more data being analyzed, it is possible for the volcanologists to tell us if there is a volcano is going to erupt. And what they do is, they study the gases which are emitting out of it. They study the sounds which are coming out of the mound, which is the volcano, where the active volcano is there. Sometimes there is a crater also in the volcanoes. And they can also study that with the behavior of animals, because it is found that when the volcano is about to erupt, the animals are more and more sensitive to those things, and the behavior of the animals also helps the volcanologists, those scientists, to predict a volcano. As I told you, there are advantages in that the ash is very good for soil, and the animals, they can make they can reside over the slopes and they can be safe. Now, the most, massive volcano which is there in Hawaii, where it is 80,000 kilometer cube, is the total volume of the volcano. Normally, the volume of the volcanoes, and these volcanoes like that in the Hawaii, they are called super volcanoes. They are very rare, and their area is, the volume is more than 10,000 kilometer cube, cubic kilometers. This is a vast mass which is there. Often the eruptions are not only through the vent, but there are certain side vents which are created, and the ash and the rocks and the molten lava, they fall, and if the material which is coming out of the molten lava has got low viscosity, then it spreads, and it spreads in the shape of what are known as the shield volcanoes. So there are conical volcanoes which are normally called steep volcanoes, and these are the composite volcanoes. Then we have the shield volcanoes, which are not very steep, where the lava is flowing to long distances, massive areas, etc. And then there are kind of cones, which are, the height is 200, 300 or less meters. And there are volcanoes which are of very small height above the sea surface, and they map the sea surface always. So volcanoes, as it is, that is the eruption of the lava, eruption of the magma chamber, and this is normally found by what we can say the sites of the plateaus. Tectonic plates. So that is the physics and chemistry is very interesting, but the main feature is that there is a pressure, and that pressure pushes the lava, the magma, up through the vent, it goes out, and sometimes it sleeps for very long periods of time. Okay, sometimes it erupts again and again. We have a study of the 10,000 years, and there we have active volcanoes to the tune of about 1,500. There may be more which we have not found. So this is about a brief introduction about the volcanoes. Thank you very much.